Simply Fujica, a place for budding and aspiring entrepreneurs. Guys, I want to welcome you back to another video. And if you're new to this channel, welcome and thank you so much for watching. Guys, today I have a video by popular demand. Guys, I receive emails from you asking, when I'm taking consultations with you, you are asking, do I need to rent an office location in order to run my home care agency? Guys, if you want to know the answer to that question, because I actually called the state to ensure that I was getting the right information, then stay tuned. So guys, before I answer that question, I kind of want to start off by telling you a little bit about my story, because what I always like to do is leave you guys with options so that you can make the best decision for you and your business. So initially, when my husband and I started and ventured off into this business opportunity, we decided to get an office at that time because we had other businesses that we were running. And so my husband in particular actually does see clients. And so we didn't want to make the full plunge into actually leasing an office. So we decided to get a virtual office. So that's the first option I want to discuss with you today, is a virtual office. What that entails, at least the agreement that we had, is that anytime that we needed to see a client or we needed to operate out of an office, we would book an office at the particular office that we had this agreement with. Now, we actually utilize Regis, and so Regis has a network of offices. And so that was nice, because if we needed to meet with a client outside of our home station, if you will, we would do the same thing. We would look for availability at that office, sign up for it, and we would be able to come in and utilize an office for that day. Typically, I want to say, don't hold me to it, but I want to say you can have 5 office visits a month. But what's really nice about it is that you have a business address that you can use. So that address does not change. However, if you need to have a physical business address, because a lot of places, and I think the state is included in this, a lot of places do not like to use P.O. boxes for business addresses. So you having a virtual office, you have that physical business address that you would need. So we went along in that way. Anytime that, I think we did a hiring event at our office, we rented out one of the conference rooms to do a hiring event. This is like in the early stages. So it really served our purpose. And I think we went with like that for about 4 or 5 months. About 5 months into it, and then as we started kind of saying, okay, we're getting ready to submit our packet for licensure. I think at that time we were getting a little bit closer to tax season for my husband. And again, we knew that our license would be approved by the state, so we just wanted to make sure we had an actual home front. We wanted to make sure that we had, you know, roots somewhere. So we actually transitioned from the virtual office to an actual lease. So that's your second option. And the question that you want to ask here is, because we were, and I don't remember the exacts, but let's say we were 6 months into our virtual office contract, you know, does that 6 months transfer over to a lease? Because the lease was a 2-year lease. And the answer to that was yes. So you want to make sure you know the answer to that based on, you know, your situation and what you decide to go and what you decide to do. And so for us, it was easy. Our business address did not change. We had an actual office. And actually, that's the office that I film all of my videos from, or film my videos out of. This is the office that you see every day. This is the office most of the time you see my videos. Sometimes I film my videos from home. But for the most part, when you see this background, you know I'm at my actual office. And so it has worked out nice for us. It has worked out very nice for us. And so we're happy with it. We're actually looking at, do we want to go into a bigger space or wait until this lease to expire and then potentially find a different workspace. So we're contemplating that now. So that is your second option. But your third option is to have an office at your home. So I looked at it, for those of you who know me well, you know I'm always on the California Department of Social Services website. I'll make sure to include that, you know, below, and I'll make sure to include that in the description. And I looked over the licensing requirements several times, and it really doesn't speak to the home office. So because I get this question a lot from you guys, I called the state. And I think there were like 30 people in line, so I just left my phone number for them to, you know, give me a call back. I think about an hour, 2 hours later, an analyst called me, and here's what she said. I even wrote it down for you. So if you have an office in your home, it is totally okay to have a separate room dedicated to your business. So in other words, because remember, when you have a home care agency, you will receive an inspection. So when that inspector comes in, they don't want to see toys all over the place. They don't want it to see that this is a bedroom, but there's a desk on the side. It has to be a dedicated office, okay? Dedicated office, and so that when the auditor comes in, they can inspect files. They can inspect all of those things that you can expect under a normal inspection. But again, this room needs to be separate from the rest of the house, meaning there really shouldn't be a lot of personal things there. And the good news that I really like about this, especially if you're first starting off, you may not have the funds to dedicate to even for a virtual office, because that is a cost. And so depending on your budget, if you're just operating, you're not yet generating income, this might be the best solution for you, okay? So if you start off at home and then you decide later to transition to an office, there is going to be a fee to do an address change, and I will have to look at, I'll make sure to include that, but I'll have to look and see what that fee amount is. But there is going to be a fee to make sure you do an address change with the state. You also want to kind of consider some things. So the positive is most likely you're not going to see a client at your office, right? Because most of the time, if you're talking about your clients, you're going to be going to their home to see them, to visit them, to onboard them, things of that nature. Now, remember, when you're doing orientations with your home aides, your home health aides, when you're, you know, getting their I-9 information, when you're having them fill out forms, when you're having those interviews, where would you do that? So that's something you kind of want to think of. That's something you want to vet out should you choose to operate from home. So guys, as always, I hope that is a value add for you. Again, other than how do you fund the initial home health agency, I think that's the second biggest question I get is, do I need to actually rent an office to run my home care agency? And now we know the answer to that is no. So again, guys, make sure that you know, as always, I always tell you guys, make sure you know the legislation for your particular state. Again, I am in California. So this is great information for my California folks. Make sure you know of what the regulations say in your state and move from there. The other item that I wanted to mention, I almost forgot, really quickly, guys. When you turn in your licensing packet, you will be assigned an analyst, okay? So these are questions, write those things down. I couldn't wait for my analyst to call me. I had a few questions that I wanted to make sure that I understood that I was interpreting legislation correctly, that I was making sure that I was interpreting requirements correctly. So remember, when you have that analyst, use that person as a resource to help you stand up your business. Okay, guys, again, I hope this was a value add for you guys. Yay, I feel so accomplished I got this information for you. So guys, do me a favor now, make sure that you like the video. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel, and if you haven't already, hit that bell notification so that you're notified every time I drop new content. Okay, guys, that's all I have for you today. Stay blessed.